long time, a lot of investment. So we need to know information about their abundance if we want to help them out. So like what Krista is doing, learning about how many animals there are, what they're up to, how are they using habitats. So we need to know about important habitats as well. Reproductive biology, essentially figuring out how long it takes for them to become sexually mature, as well as demographics. So things like fecundity, where you need to know how many of the females in the population are actually available to reproduce. And we want to see, looking at who's coming up and the future generations of who may be available. These things that take decades of research to figure out. And we're trying to skip a few decades by doing this instead. So we've tried it out. And traditional ways of doing it, we would usually rely on post-mortems, so dead dolphins that wash up whenever they wash up. There's no way of controlling how representative these dolphins are. They could be super skinny, they could be malnourished. We have no idea what's happened to them most of the time. We could, if we were allowed to, do health assessments. So we capture the dolphins every year, do all the measurements, do all the interviews, release them. But it's very invasive. Nobody likes being tackled and having a tooth pulled out. It's not the best way to do it. But this is essentially how you get the most information from a live animal. Captivity, no one's a big fan of that. And it's not representative of the wild. So they move differently, they eat differently, everything is different, so it's no good. And the long-term monitoring. So we've just started here in Mandurah, but we have information dating back a few decades, which is really cool. And what I wanted to do was combine long-term data with morphology, so size and length of these dolphins, and see what we can come up with. So there's a two-factor objective. So the first one was method. We want to find out, can we use this technique successfully to figure out morphometric data, essentially, on free-ranging dolphins, so animals that are wild. We're not doing anything to harm them. We're not touching them. We want to see how good is this technique on these wild dolphins. And then we want to apply this technique. So we want to create these growth curves, which you'll see in a minute, with age and length. And we can do a whole bunch of things from that. So life history parameters, we can estimate the size at birth. We can estimate the size at first calf for the females, which is pretty cool. We can also look at other growth factors. We can also look at ecology. So how big are these dolphins compared to other populations of the same species? Are these inshore animals bigger or smaller than the offshore animals? And how much evidence is there to suggest that there is a different population inshore as opposed to offshore? All of these things you can answer by just taking photos. So we tried that. Here's the camera. You can see the two lasers. These lasers are no different to what I would be using if I had one on here. That's a class 3A laser. Very safe. If you're always watching out for the dolphin's eyes when you're doing it, but you would have to hold it this far from your eye for over 2 minutes before you can do any damage. So that's never going to happen. And you just focus as usual. As soon as you focus, the lasers turn on, and you just take a photo of the dolphin surfaces. We calibrate it here every day, make sure it's 10 centimeters, accurate to about 2 millimeters. So 2 millimeters was my cutoff point. If it's more than that, the day gets scrapped. If it's less, that's good. And it's just going out on the boat, getting photos, it's pretty good fun. And this is the sort of ideal photo we're after. Two green dots under the yellow arrows. You can see there, it's calibrated to 10 centimeters. And what we do from that is, hopefully you can see the pixels. We're converting pixels into real length using our computer software. Because we have this known, so let's say that's 50 pixels across, we know 10 centimeters, and then we can just convert it.